Howdy, I'm Kirsty Meekie, and welcome to the Naio Nails channel, direct and live from my home. Okay, we're not live, but yeah. We're in lockdown, so we are filming from home. And I say filming we, because Adam is on Facebook Messenger.
Hello, everybody.
He's going to direct me. He can see the screen. We have two cameras.
I could do the voiceover from here, doesn't that really?
Yeah. We have two cameras. We have the Kirsty cam and the overhead cam. And then Adam can see the overhead camera, so he can direct me still. So yeah.
Upstage, downstage.
Yep. So today we are going to have an experiment. I've never done this before. Adam said, do you want to try it before you film it? And I went, no, do you know what? We'll just do it, and any problems that arise, we'll just talk through it, and hopefully you'll find it enjoying. You'll enjoy, like, the whole process. So, yeah, we're going to do a art technique that's used on canvases and things like that. We're going to try and do it on nails. It's a drag-through effect. So, I have my nails, they are already prepped. By that I mean I've removed the surface shine. I'm just crossing my legs underneath, you know, I like to sit like that. Those of you that are new to the channel won't know that. But yeah, I cross my legs like I'm in some position. So, I'm going to do a white base. I'm going to do white because I just want to have something that's going to contrast. And I want to try a few different ways of doing this. And I want you to join me on this journey. And I'm going to do two coats of this. So I'm going to put one thin coat of Snow White. I want to call it then. Yes, it is called Snow White. Why did I
forget? It is called Snow White, yeah.
I'm going to do two that are white. The other one won't be white. We'll choose the colour for that later in the video. So I suppose this isn't so much as it's a tutorial, but it's
an experiment.
It's an experiment. Like, come and play with Kirsty Meekie and we are doing experimentals. The first try thing, well, the first way I'm going to do it is we're going to use wet on wet. So none of it's going to be set. So,
you confused me there.
So the first layer is set, the second layer of white, so the second coat of white is not going to be cured. And this is the first way I'm going to do this. I'm just going to pop that there so I don't knock it. I'm going to get my palette, I'm going to get my chain. So we're going to do it with chain. Naio sell this in many different colours. Doesn't matter what colour it is, we're just going to use whatever. Doesn't really matter because the chain will add nothing, only a pattern. And then what we're going to do is I'm going to coat the chain with Serious Black. Maybe a little bit further up. So it's saturated in Serious Black. We're going to pick the chain up. We're going to wait for it to stop swinging. I have no idea if this is going to work. Right, so we've laid that on. And now, I'm going to pull this down. Oh my God, that looks amazing.
Does look very cool.
Oh my God, the gate of the lab were quick. Oh my God, that was so satisfying. Well, I've got like my little bath of a lint-free wipe and some gel residue wipe off solution to just clean off my chain, because you can reuse this, you don't need to throw it away. Can clean that off. Look at it! That is so cool. I'm really impressed. Sorry. I'm just shocked that it actually works, because a canvas is a little bit different than a nail. I'm going to matte top coat this before it all goes to
like a feather sort of.
It is, isn't it? Or like a feather, calla lily kind of shape. Oh, I love that. That is so nice. Right, I want to do it in blooming gel now. So, I want it. Do we need another? No, I think that'll be fine. Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to put blooming gel on instead of white. And we've got a white background and it's white enough. It'll do. It's fine. It's an experiment. So I'm going to put blooming gel on now. And then I'm going to get a chain again and just lay it straight on top of that gel. And then I'm just going to move that gel around. I've dried that brush off. It didn't go in with like a wet brush. So I'm just utilising what I've already got on this palette. So I'm not wasting too much. I am going to go a little bit higher though this time. Okay, so I'm gonna just wiggle this down. And I want it to come straight, so I'm gonna hold the chain. I want to let it bloom a little bit now. So with that one, I kind of held here so it pulled really straight. Because I've seen them on canvases and they have like a little, they like put it, the chain through like a tube. And then pull it so it always stays in one position. So that was something that I wanted to try. Rather than kind of teasing where you're actually pulling it, I wanted to see how different that looped. And I obviously did one, two, three, was there four little loops that I did? Whereas this one only had a few. Oh, just look at that mint. Now with the blooming gel, you can see the edges are blooming. Not so much in the middle, just the edges. So it kind of feathers it more. So I reckon if we did that, and we just did two little loops like we did with that one, and I put the blooming gel on it, it'd look even more feather like, wouldn't it? All right, let me pop that in the lamp. Now, this one I want to do different colors, so what if we did a pale green? So, this is this color. Adam, you're gonna have to find it because I don't have a sticker for the name.
What number was it?
It's 693. I want two coats of that colour.
It's called Mint to Be.
Mint to Be. What a cool name. And I'm going to make a new cleaning bath and bath, my gel residue white gloss solution bath with a lint-free pad and some gel residue white gloss solution. Okay, I'm getting a little bit messy. Are you surprised? So this is Periwinkle. I'm going to do a line of that. But what I want to do is put blooming gel on here again. We have to have wet on wet. It's the uncured gel polish that will give you that effect. So let's put our chain in to the gel, take off the excess, and then we can just smudge that in to the chain. Now let's get our chain. And pull down. Right, I'm going to matte this. So I want it to look like it's actual paper on a canvas. I don't want it to be glossy. Right, so on this one, I'm going to do things a little bit different. What I'm going to do is I am going to put the gel on first. I'm going to put matte on. I'm going to put matte on first. And then I'm going to use some colours So I'm going to use this colour, which is pitch purple. And I'm just going to put some of this onto my palette. I want to try orange. I know that's like really random, but I want to put colours together that probably wouldn't necessarily put together. And a little bit of white. Right, so I'm going to take the pitch purple and come around like this. And then I'm going to get the orange, put that next to it, and the white. Then we're going to take the chain. Come around the edge. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Adam, if you could see my face. Wow! That's amazing!
That was very cool.
That was so satisfying. Oh my God. Shit, that works really well. Let's top coat this with matte. You could shine it. Now my creative juices are really flowing. I really want to actually see if I can do a butterfly now. This is what I'd show you the picture. So this is on a canvas. It's bigger chain as well. So I wonder if we could do a butterfly. Even if it's just one wing, you know what I mean? Let me see. So yeah, I definitely think I should do it on a canvas because I'm so excited about it. And with all that, the nail products, oh my God. You get some nice big chain, don't I? Right, so all I've done with this nail is apply the two coats of, oh God, what's it called? Mint to be.
It's mint to be.
Right, so this is my idea. We're going to go in with the matte top coat. And you could use normal top coat. It's just that I'm going to make it matte anyway, so I might as well use that as my wet product. Right, so I'm actually going to do this in the shape of a butterfly's wings. And hopefully it will work. So let's go with the orange. And you know what? I really love the colour combination. Because if we look at this one, that colour combo is actually bloody gorgeous. And then we'll do the white. Nervous, not gonna lie. Chain. Now we've really got to be a bit more precise where the chain goes. Kind of once you make contact like that, it will stick. So we're gonna come round the edge of the butterfly shape. And I think I'm gonna have to do one at a time. So I'm gonna pull. Oh my God! Look at that. That's amazing. Okay. Now the other one. And we're always pulling to this point. And then pull. Oh my God. Can you believe it? Can you believe it?
Very cool.
Can you believe it? I have made a butterfly.
That is very cool.
So the main thing that I have to focus on when I'm doing it is making sure I'm pulling to the right place, so it's controlling your chain. I mean, everything else was pretty straightforward, really. You didn't have to be neat when you did the shape of the butterfly wings. But what I want to do now is I want to use black, and I want to add detail to it now. So you could leave it like it is, and that would be absolutely fine. So the only thing that I don't like is that little bit there, kind of needed to make sure my chain didn't pull into that. But we're going to hide that. So I'm going to use the black. And I'm actually going to... Oh, do you know what I am going to do? Oh, now I am excited. Sorry. Let me matte top coat this. Because what I'm going to do is I'm going to work on top of the matte. Because it sticks really nice. Gel polish loves to stick to matte top coat. So in theory, when I do my black detail, it's going to be really sharp. Yeah? You know what? I'm just going to add some swirly bits to this. Oh, just, I'm sorry, but this is just amazing. If you don't like this, then you go away. Well, I think maybe going around with a bit of white. Let's try this. And let's just pull some lines from the edge. I prefer this.
Yeah, just a bit
wishy-washy. And we can still do a body. I don't want to do any more. I think that's all you need, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Let's pop that in the lamp. So this one I added some black swirls to, and it can't, I love this. This now that looks like a feather, I think. Because look at a feather.
Oh, a feather.
Because look at the lines.
Mm, yeah.
It's just like a feather. Now this one that we did with the marbling. So you can still add to it once you've done your technique. I'm just adding a little bit of detail, just some swirly bits, just to add to it, that's all. Right, so we have a look at these ones. So I've gone over with the black, haven't I, and added some bits of detail. Now, if you want to keep them shiny, you will need to go over with, and I'll show you on one of them for an example, go over with the top coat, just on that artwork. So you're kind of tracing what you've already done. Going to pop that in, and if you want it all to be matte, obviously you can put your matte top coat on. And we'll do that with these two. And then with this one, I'm just going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution just to take off the sticky layer of the white and show you what that looks like without actually going over with top coat or matte. So we still get like a slightly raised bits of the white art, but it's not overly raised, and it goes kind of matte, like a satin finish it goes to. So if you wanted these details to be shiny, you could make them shiny by just, you know, you can go over with your top coat and do that if you want them shiny, but if you want them like they are, that's fine. Or you could completely matte the whole thing. It's entirely up to you. So we've got a good variation of different things that you can do with the drag through effect. Oh my god, do you know what, this video has gone 4 better than I could have ever wished for. I am super happy, and I hope you all have a little go. I never thought it would you could do this on nails. I mean, how amazing.
It's very cool.
I actually really like this one. There you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook, because Adam is editing videos to put on Facebook as well. We're also on Instagram, and I will see you in the next video. Love you all. Bye-bye.
And it's like that thing that sorry you did yesterday where nothing's going to be the same. It's
very
unique.
I'm really happy with that. My God. Oh, Donna's just sent a picture saying about to hit the shops, girls. Don't show you the picture.
Really bad.
Oh, yes. Full projection. And Adam says bye-bye. And Adam says bye-bye. Say bye-bye.
Hang on. I've said, oh no, I can't.
Say bye-bye.
Hang on.
What do you mean, hang on?
Where's it? It's because I'm trying to record it on my end. Bye-bye.
There we are. Thank you. Bloody hell.